गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट बिहेवियर थेरेपी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। बिहेवियर थेरेपी, दिस थेरेपी फोकस्ड ऑन द बिहेवियर एंड थॉट्स ऑफ द क्लाइंट इन द प्रेजेंट। द पास्ट इज रेलिवेंट ओनली टू एक्सटेंड ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग द ओरिजिन्स ऑफ द फॉल्टी बिहेवियर एंड थॉट पैटर्न्स नॉट रिलीव्ड। So here you can see here about behavior. Behavior is adaptive and maladaptive. Maladaptive behavior is when it is inappropriate, interferes with adaptive functioning, and others misunderstand it in the terms of cultural inappropriateness. So that is behavior, maladaptive behavior. Here is about behaviorism. Behaviorism see psychological disorders as the result of maladaptive learning. As people are born tabula rasa, a blank slate, so basic assumptions is that the maladaptive behavior can be corrected through the provision of adequate learning experiences. It can be corrected with some methods and techniques. So here about behavioral therapy, a form of psychotherapy, the goal of which is to modify maladaptive behavior patterns by reinforcing more adaptive behavior. Here are some principles of behavioral therapy. Theory of classical conditioning, as we have already discussed about in class 11th, classical conditioning and operant conditioning. Classical conditioning given by Mr. Pavlov, it involves learning by association and is usually the cause of most phobias. Next theory is operant conditioning, involves learning by reinforcement. For example, rewards and punishment can explain abnormal behavior such as eating disorder. That is operant conditioning. Next is assumptions of behavioral therapy. So some assumptions are here on screen based on principles and procedure of scientific method, and it deals with clients' current problems as opposed to analysis of historical determinants and factors influencing them and factors that can be used to modify performance. So the client expected to assume an active role by engaging specific actions to deal with their problems. Next assumptions are here. Fourth assumption, it emphasizes teaching clients skills of self-management with expectation they are responsible for transferring what is learned in office in everyday lives, and it focuses on assessing overt and covert behavior. Overt and covert behavior, you all know about these two types of behavior directly, and identifying problem and evaluating change. Next is, it emphasizes a self-control approach in which client learn self-management strategies. In behavioral therapies, are clinical application of learning theories. These are clinical applications. Next is intervention individually tailored to specific problems. What treatment by whom is most effective for this individual with that specific problem and under which set of circumstances, and it is based on collaborative partnership between the therapist and client. Clients inform about nature and course of RX. Next is, it emphasizes on practical application. Intervention applied to all facets of daily life in which maladaptive behavior are to be decreased and adaptive behavior are to be increased. So therapists strive to develop culture specific procedure and obtain clients' adherence and cooperation. That is, these are some assumptions, and we have discussed about what is behavioral therapy, and it consists of a large set of specific techniques and interventions. Symptoms of client, the clinical diagnosis are the guiding factor in the selection of specific techniques or intervention to be applied. And it is used open therapy. Open therapy, the therapist share his or her method with the client. So this is a behavioral therapy. And in next video, we will discuss about method of treatment and behavioral techniques. So that's it for today. Thank you.